In 1975, he directed Jaws. In 1978, he directed Close Encounters of the Third Kind. In 1981, he directed Raiders of the Lost Ark. And now, Steven Spielberg brings us E.T., the Extraterrestrial.
E.T. was on my mind maybe for 15, 20 years, perhaps for a number of years somewhat subconsciously as a fantasy of mine, as a way to, you know, to make myself feel less lonely in my life. And also, it was a childhood fantasy to tell the story of a best friend and a special friend who rescues a young boy from the sadness of a divorce. So E.T. sort of came about in stages for me.
I was the writer, and then I became the associate producer on the movie, and I think the main reason I was associate producer is so that I would feel obliged to show up every day, which I probably would have done anyway. But I was lucky enough to be involved with many different aspects of the movie as it went along, including the shooting, of course. But in pre-production, I got to sit in on the casting, meet all the children.
I'm keeping him.
What is it?
He won't hurt you, Gertie.
I was in town, and I had done two other things before that. And I was doing post-production work on one of these projects and didn't really even have an agent. And somehow I got this meeting set up and went in for an audition.
Can't take him.
Well, I'm afraid I have to, son.
Can't take him away, he's mine!
But it's not my choice. The president asked me to come here and get him.
I don't care what the president says, he's my best friend. You can't take him away!
Everybody in the room was in tears. I just remember turning to Henry and saying, okay, kid, you got the part.
Okay, kid, you got the job.
At first, he really just wants to meet you and get to know you, you know, and I was so happy to have a grown-up that would listen to me talk, you know, and he believed in my stories and he loved them and it made me feel so good and alive.
She's 6 years old, and she told me that she's going to do a 20-city tour in America with her punk rock band. And then she kept making up stories, and they got bigger and bigger and bigger and wilder and wilder, and she just blew me away. I mean, there was no second choice. I mean, Drew Barrymore was the first choice for this part.
You can't tell. Not even Mom.
Why not?
Because grown-ups can't see them. Only little kids can see them.
Give me a break.
Actually, interviewing with him was really good because he was saying, you know, what do you like to do? And I said, ride bikes and, you know, play Dungeons and Dragons. And he said, well, that's in the movie. And it was just a real natural, relaxing interview.
Well, I thought Robert was just a really good actor. He had stage experience. He was the most professional of all the kids. And he was the one that really, you know, was the anchor because he had worked and he had been in front of people before acting. And he was real solid.
I really think that a big part of the reason the movie hasn't aged very much and it feels somewhat timeless is because, in a sense, it was never designed to be an effects movie. And so, even though we had to create that creature with the technology that existed then, Steven shot E.T. as a character.
It first started with myself and Carlo Rambaldi working directly with Steven, doing drawings of E.T. And in the early stages, we didn't really know what E.T. was going to look like because we were just sort of talking about him, okay? I think that we actually, at some point fairly early on, had set down some ground rules. That is that E.T. isn't the monster.
As I remember saying to Carlo, here's some pictures of Albert Einstein, Ernest Hemingway, and Carl Sandburg. I love their eyes. Can we make E.T.'s eyes as frivolous and also wizened and as sad as those three icons.
The thing I really remember very specifically working with Stephen was actually going into his office and he's having all these books and saying, here, those are neat eyes, that's a neat mouth, look at this person. And I mean, they were really interesting because they would be some very, very, very old people. And you'd get these very old, wizened eyes and stuff. And he would say, yeah, he said, you see that, that's nice. The way we worked with this stuff is Carlo and I would go away for a day or two and we would just draw a lot of stuff. We would just basically shotgun. And then we would go back to Stephen's office, and we would basically pin the stuff up on the wall, and then Stephen would look at them and say, well, you know, I like that, or I like a bit of this, or that's an interesting nose, or whatever.
Carl did a number of versions in clay, and I stood over Carlo and worked with him. I'm not an artist, so I didn't touch the clay, but I would say, too scary, too Disney, too sweet. And finally, this creature did emerge from clay after a couple of weeks that was E.T. that became E.T.
It was always very real to me.
Yeah. It was amazing once everything was set to go and the cameras were rolling and you were in the scene, everything was incredibly real.
Really young, and our whole lives changed, and we couldn't go anywhere, and you know, all of a sudden you couldn't eat, you know, a meal without somebody coming up to you. And trying to embrace life on that level, I think, was hard, being as young as we were. But I know that, you know, we did it really well, which is really cool.
I don't know how much it changed me, because I've never lived without having done it, you know. So I know that it changed a lot of things for me, and it opened a lot of doors for me and did a lot of good.
I think that it afforded so many opportunities that I know I certainly would never have had without it.
It opened me up to more personal stories. Color Purple followed soon after that. Then came Empire of the Sun, and finally Schindler's List. It was this, in a way, a ladder on a course of a kind of personal movie about human characters and human exploits and the human condition, as opposed to the other movies, which are much more, you know, adventures and films like Jaws and the Raiders films and Jurassic Park. So my career sort of gone, you know, on two different roads that parallel one another. There's this kind of film, there's that kind of film. And I think E.T. gave me the courage to start creating that kind of film.
Cut. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Lovely. I like that. Yeah.